If we take any imaginable thing out of its context, then the thing will lose its defining characteristics. It can be material or abstract. Let's think about a car. If we isolate the idea of a specific car from other cars, our car can be defined as good or bad, expensive or cheap, fast or slow. It's because there is no conventional standard to compare the car to. It's just a car, or more specifically and yet more ambiguously, it is. Wait a second. If the car can be, then the car can be regarded as a being. So the car is still a form of consciousness, but an inferior one. But how can we say it's inferior? Inferior to what? Well, the car is a form of consciousness inferior to the human form of consciousness because it can't move or speak. That was not a valid argument, now was it? Cars can definitely move, otherwise they wouldn't drive them. And they can definitely speak, especially with the current development of artificial intelligence. The argument I was looking for was that cars don't possess free will or souls. That's why they're inferior types of consciousness. In this car example, we used human consciousness as a conventional standard. This is where the law of relativity comes into play. We compare every new thing to the idea of human potential. Whenever a new type of robot is invented, we want to see if it's just as good as a human or even better. After all, we are humans, and so far this is the highest level of material consciousness we can think of. The law of relativity also states that there are better or worse places to be in compared to the place you're now in. Before complaining about working 8 hours a day on the same boring job, you should know that it's true, you're not in the best place, but you're not in the worst place either. Being born with a silver spoon in your mouth is still a thing, and so is modern day slavery. If your current job is intolerably boring, then you can get a better job. This is the fundamental idea of Stoicism, and it says that you should do something about the things you don't like, and if there's nothing you can do, then don't complain about them. And if we're talking about working hours and jobs, then we inevitably have to talk about money. And when it comes to the financial situation of the people, everything becomes binary. One or zero, have or have nots. And that is an exaggeration because having literally no money is impossible. Even if you don't have any cash, which hopefully is only temporary, you might have some money in the form of credit, commodities, real estate, and so on. It's not about not having money, it's about having little money. But what is considered little in that case? You can meet your basic needs or you can buy a new car? It's all relative. Even if you have $100 million right now, it's still little money comparing to being a billionaire. The difference between these two financial titles is huge. Check this example. 1 million seconds is 11 days. 1 billion seconds is around 31 years. Nowadays, people say that being a millionaire is the new middle class. And yes, I'm talking about US dollars. Being a millionaire at the beginning of the 20th century meant you are the richest person on the planet. Everything is relative, and the fact that we know it shows that we ain't fooling around. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to hit the like button, share the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and stay cool.